We're live.
We're live.
Hello.
Greetings,
hello.
America, and all over the world.
Welcome back to the pod.
Welcome back.
4K's in a pod.
4K's in a pod right
That's
here.
Right.
And we are glad to be back. We have some amazing friends that we're going to tell you guys about in just a second. But for you guys that have never heard of the 4Ks in a Pod podcast before, first of all, we welcome you. Second of all, we want to give you our mission statement to build stronger friendships and to network those friends to other friends through various stories, fun topics, and enlightening interviews. That's why we're here, guys.
Our Bible verse of the day is Psalms 103, verse 1 and 2. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
Praise the Lord. Great. He's benefited us greatly. I promise you that.
Can't go wrong with Psalms.
Can't go wrong with Psalms, Katie. You didn't sing your song. There we go. And then also, we so appreciate you guys emailing us. We've got many, many emails. I'm going to try to read this one from Miss Whitney. It says, hey, Kris, Kody, Katie, and Keith, ever since I was little, I've always enjoyed listening to your music. I've been to many of your concerts, but I officially met y'all on the Singing at Sea in 2023, which would have been last year, because y'all were our hosts. I noticed that not only are y'all great singers, but y'all are also very sweet and kind people. I love your music and the message that's behind every song y'all sing. I hope to see y'all in Georgia really soon. Also, my question is, what is one big event you look forward to every year? NQC, Singing News, etc. What are you guys? I'll give mine. And it's
we just did Praise Fest. I love Praise Fest.
Praise Fest is wonderful.
That's a fun one.
Praise Fest is good.
All the IMC dates are great.
Yep, that's right.
One event, that's tough.
Mm-hmm.
It's tough. You can't say the cruise either.
I'd say I always like the cruises, specifically the one that's coming up in September. I'm really excited about.
Yes. I'll give the one for this week. Y'all know, and I'm going to be boring here. My favorite week of the year is not necessarily a big event. It's a big event to me, and it's Bass Attack. And we are here right now. It's the 33rd Bass Attack in beautiful Broadus, Texas. We're fixing to go fishing with a bunch of pastors and laymen and deacons from all over the country. And it's a little casual tournament that Dad started putting on many years ago with a couple buddies. And now it's grown to 40 or 50 guys. And we're fixing to go bass fishing.
I knew whenever we came in here to record that this was not going to be an episode without mentioning Bass Attack.
You knew it was happening.
I knew it was going to happen.
Especially in this room. We're in an old sanctuary now, fellas and ladies, that we grew up listening to Dad preach in and us singing in. And they used to have pews in here, and used to pack it out.
Yeah.
And so it's a lot of great memories in here. So did everybody give a big event?
I'll do Praise Fest.
Praise Fest.
I'll agree with
one.
That.
That's a great one.
I say cruises.
Yes. Whitney, thank you for just cruises.
Whitney. Thank you.
Thank you, Whitney, for
come cruise again with us.
That's right. For your email and for all of you who do that, we can't thank you enough. Again, the email address is the word for FOUR, the letter K and the word pod, 4kpod@yahoo.com. We would love to hear from you. If you have questions for us, if you have anything that you'd like to hear about us or maybe what we do, we would love to hear from you with whatever you have.
Right.
And so we kind of sped through that, guys.
Yes.
And there's for good reason.
Stuff out of the
for
way.
Good reason.
For very good reason. We have some of our dearest friends across the table from us, and this is going to be such a fun episode.
Hey there, and welcome to 4Ks in a Pod with the Erwins. My name is Luke, and I'm the producer of this podcast, and I'm so glad that you've joined us for this episode. Now, listening to the podcast is a wonderful way to get to know the Erwin family, but if you want to meet them in person, then you might be able to catch them live on tour. And if you want to find all of the different tour dates and seeing where you can catch them performing live, then you're going to want to head over to their website, erwinministries.com. Now, I'm really excited to introduce your co-host, Keith, Kody, Kris, and Katie. They are the 4Ks in a Pod.
Bring on the fire. Bring on the rain. My testimony is not going to change. From the valley to the mountain, he's worthy of praise. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story.
Guys, the sound.
We're talking. Yes. Let's go. We're talking God is real. Yes. We're talking. Can I get a witness? We're talking First Church of Mercy.
That's right.
Hit after hit after
We're
hit.
Talking number one
it was
after
grace,
number
which
one.
Is my favorite.
Hey. Oh, yeah.
Love it.
Thank you. Thank
love
you.
It.
I would have loved it if you just pulled a deep cut off of like our first album.
Yes. Yes.
Man, these we guys are sound with these guys are awesome, and I'm telling you, I don't know how you wouldn't, but if you don't know who these guys are, you're missing out. You That's have right. to look their music up. Some of the three most talented guys we've ever been around. They're right. ministers and they're worshipers, but I'm telling you, they're world class at what they do. Yeah. But even better, they're great men off stage. They're people. And they love loving on their people that are around them. And we're just thankful. We're thankful that that you guys are here.
So. Glad to be here.
So for people that might not know you guys, we're sitting with Rob Mills, right. which is the dad of the bunch. Yep. And then his wonderful wife, Miss Angie, is not here today.
Yeah.
Maybe next time we can get her around the pod. And then we have their two sons, Jacob and Levi. Right. With us as well. So the Mills family, but they go by the sound. So y'all kind of give just a rundown of how everything got started, your history with the sound before with your boys, just kind of a backstory of it all.
It got started when Angie and I...
not that far back.
Oh, okay.
Not that far back.
Reel it in. Reel it in.
Dad played with the sound from 90 to 92, and they were a little different back then. Now, the sound was originally from Texas, they were from over in the Houston area, but they went through a lot of different iterations over the years. They started as like a quartet. They were based out of a church over near Houston, and they sang quartet music. When Dad joined them, there was a big shakeup, and you guys went to more of like a country gospel kind of a sound when you guys were with them, and then... After you left, the sound became like a 90s contemporary
Chicago group. Feel.
Yeah, it was, and it was very 90s. If you go back and listen to it, it was like quintessentially 90s. It was really cool.
Wow.
But then they kind of fizzled out around 2000. Everybody kind of went their separate ways, and Dad was only with them from 90 to 92. Mm-hmm. But then we started playing music together. We grew up playing music together. In 2017, we got the name The Sound because we had always really liked it.
Right.
And then 2019, started releasing music. Yep. So
wow,
nice.
So you were at The Sound in 1991 and 1992.
Yeah,
Brother Rob, I was born in 1992.
Keith Erwin, yes,
sir. I started there when
nice.
I was three. I was 3 years old.
Yeah, you okay? There you go.
Yeah. 3 years old.
I could barely carry in the speakers.
Yeah, you're the bus driver.
Yeah, I was the bus driver.
So that's kind of the sound history. Mm-hmm. The boys, Jacob and Levi, tell me y'all, because y'all have some incredible background in theater, if I'm not mistaken. I know
a
little bit.
Some. So. When we were, I've been singing since I was very, very small. We've got recordings on answering machines of I was like 2 years old.
Wow.
But I didn't, I started singing in church, 6, 7, 8 years old, somewhere in there.
Yeah.
And Jake really didn't start playing music. He was like 10.
10. It was around 10 years old.
Yeah. Nice.
Wow.
So,
What inspired you to do it? What made you want to start playing?
I really don't know. Just being around it,
yeah,
I guess,
course.
You know.
You're obviously around it a lot.
Yeah. No, literally, this kid woke up one day and said, I think I want to play music. Yeah. And Dad was like, well, I don't know, you want to play bass?
Yeah, so I started playing bass.
Started with the bass.
Yeah, around the time I started singing. Cool. Yeah,
and at this
then
point,
moved over.
You were a music pastor, weren't you? Is that right? That's what I thought.
I was minister of music for 16 years.
In Michigan.
Wow.
In Michigan.
That's what I thought.
Because
that's where
Miss Angie's from. Different churches, yeah.
Yep, and you're from North Carolina.
Right, Maggie Valley,
North Carolina.
North Carolina. I met Angie when I was traveling out of North Carolina with a different group. So.
Okay, wow.
Went to Michigan, and she came to a concert. And
it's crazy.
Wow, she fell in love.
That's right.
That's talent.
That's talent.
That's some talent right there.
And you have another sibling.
We do.
Emily.
We haven't even met.
Okay. You haven't
met
Emily?
Sure, she's great.
Wait a minute.
I've not met.
That's right. Yeah.
I'm sure she's great.
I've not met her.
Okay. I don't think we have.
You know what's really funny? So Emily, she is our youngest sibling. She is 22. And she's 22. That's bad that I didn't know that. I thought
we'll edit it.
Or make it sound exactly. She's 22.
Yeah. We don't know how old we are half the time.
So she's never really been involved in music, never really had much of an interest in it.
Never cared to.
Matter of fact, I don't know that I've ever really heard her sing.
She's got to be able to.
Does she know what y'all do?
Has she ever come to hear y'all sing?
Well, here's the thing. So she lives in Michigan. Jake and I live in Nashville. And so she doesn't, you know, she's not around many music things that we do.
Right.
And so nobody believes she's real. Everybody's like, you guys have a sister? And we're like, yeah. And they're like, And so
I don't believe it.
Last November, she went on the Gaither cruise with us, and everybody was like shocked. Like they were, she's real. Yeah, oh my gosh, she's here.
Aww.
She got to, a lot of people got to meet her then, but I didn't really, you would have met her at Jake's wedding, but.
Her name is Emily?
Yes.
Emily.
Okay, Emily. Yep. Well, I hope to meet her, because if she's as awesome as y'all are, she's awesome.
Well, just.
Pretty cool.
She's awesome.
Yeah, just, she and Levi look a lot alike.
Really?
I think so, too. I thought so at the wedding. Really? Yeah, I think so, too. So now that we're on weddings as well, the two boys just got married.
Yes.
Jake and Bree, y'all got married a couple years ago.
Yep, two and a half years ago.
Yes.
2.5 years ago.
And then Levi and Rachel just got married.
February 24th.
So that's just a couple days ago.
Yep.
Crazy.
Not even a month yet. Golly. At the time of this recording.
Yeah.
Wow. Another great artist in her own right.
Yes. Yeah.
Another great artist in her own right.
She is.
Absolutely. And Bree, is she? What does she do?
She is an accountant. I was going to say something else, but I was just like, now
tell her. She does a lot of different things. She's very talented.
Yeah.
Right. I like totals.
And Miss Angie.
She's my wife.
Yeah. She's pretty.
And Miss Angie, she doesn't. Does she work?
She's a dental hygienist.
Is she really?
But
how did I not know
that? Whoa. Okay. Yeah. I didn't know that either.
Yeah. No, she's a dental hygienist. Now, She has only worked like part time.
Okay.
Most of the time since we've been married. So especially once we started having kids.
Right.
She went to a part time.
I see.
Her brother's a dentist, and so she's had a little freedom as far as
I see.
That's convenient.
Her work schedule.
I know that y'all are in the process of moving to Nashville right now.
Right.
To have most of the family there.
Yeah, but I'll still go back there for dental work.
Yeah,
you know
yes,
what?
Sir. Yes, sir.
You know what? You all do have great teeth.
Check out these choppers.
I didn't know that at all.
So guys, again, these three gentlemen here, their music is fantastic, and you need to look them up. We'll give the website here before we hold out further, but we got to have some questions.
Yeah,
we have some questions we want to get to, and so this is one thing. It doesn't have to necessarily be about music, just kind of maybe a hobby or whatever. What is the one thing that you're thinking that maybe in the last few months that you would like to master? Maybe something that you feel like you maybe are not as good as you'd like to be at. Oh. Is there something?
Golf. No doubt.
That's a cool one.
I'm going to throw my name on that one, too.
Yes.
Absolutely.
No doubt.
Of course, I don't think I'm ever going to master golf.
Oh, no, you can't.
Nobody ever masters golf.
That's the beauty of it.
Yeah.
That's the beauty of it.
Keeps coming back.
And we've been playing pickleball with you guys lately.
Yeah.
We did on the cruise, and we did here the other day in our hometown. Yeah. So that'd be so much
fun. Pickleball's my jam.
Come on now.
Golf, I'm not any good. I like to golf, but that doesn't mean I'm good at golf. Pickleball, I like to
golf. See, I didn't know y'all golfed.
Well, see, I like what somebody once said something very wise. It's that golf is a sport that can be taught. It just can't be learned.
That's true.
That's good. You're right.
That's what happens with me.
That's good.
Exactly right, brother. So, you're right.
I've seen videos of Bree golfing.
Oh, yeah. We go to the driving range.
Posting it on Instagram.
Yeah. Yeah.
Have y'all done Top Golf yet?
Oh, yeah. Yes.
That's fun.
There's a Top Golf.
Do you strike the ball all the way to the back of the net?
I usually go over the net. I have to like hit like a 5-iron to the net.
He's banned
at 5 different ones. You know, they started in Dallas. Dallas is the hub. There's four in Dallas.
Wow. Yeah. Why have we not done this?
Yeah, we need to go. We'll go.
In the States, they were. It started in England or London.
We haven't gone to Topgolf with you guys yet?
Topgolf started overseas?
It started overseas, and they brought the concept here.
The hub is Dallas, yeah.
Because it's so unique because, it's like a cross between bowling
for sure.
Yes.
It absolutely. They put the
and not putt-putt, but the driving range.
Right. Yes. They put one of the ones in Dallas. I don't know if you've been to it yet. It's the one on the north side somewhere, like Frisco or Plano. They have the actual putty. They putt-putt too, and it's the actual greens. Like, really? You've seen, like, videos. It's the real deal. Like, right. It's connected to Topgolf. Wow. So they've kind of bought into this.
That's cool.
Topgolf, you're hearing this. We're giving you a plug. We want you to be our sponsor.
Yeah. Yes.
There we go.
So that's kind of what last time we went sponsored by Topgolf.
Who won? Kris got lucky and did win.
Kris got lucky and won.
Yeah, Angry Birds. Looking at you, Angry Birds.
Oh, it's,
have y'all played that
last time?
Have y'all played it?
I love it.
Angry Birds is fun.
I like that.
Yes. Oh,
it's great. Yeah, so it's better than the actual.
I agree. And it's not about how far you hit it or how close you hit it. You literally are aiming for the castle like that on the TV. And you hit it towards that direction and you watch the screen and see what you do.
It's fun.
Oh, it's fun.
Really?
Oh, yeah, it's great.
Wait, so Kris won at the Angry Birds?
Dude. So it didn't run necessarily.
Hey, maybe in a couple weeks when we're not. Nashville, we can all go to talk to
him. But if you don't know what the other,
it's a terrible game.
If you don't know, like, the I can just imagine, like, the bay next to us, they're like, they are horrible,
right?
Because we're like shanking them left and aiming way over here.
You gotta watch the television.
But we're playing the Angry Birds.
Yeah.
That's funny.
All right. Keith seems a little, like, I said, wait, Kris won? And Keith goes, he's like, he's
so competitive.
That's not something that he needs to win at.
It's just because he didn't teach it to me. I just learned it.
Yeah. Keith seems a little bitter about that one.
I am.
We were in Nashville at Topgolf, and of course, we had the bay, and, you know, we were doing our thing, and we're just a bunch of hacks, you know.
Yeah.
But these poor guys, college kids, come, and they've got their, they like come in with their own clubs, and dude, they are striking this ball. When you can hear it screaming when they leave, you know. Right. It's like, oh, mercy.
Showing off.
Yeah.
I know. Like, who would bring their own clubs to Topgolf?
Yeah, I can't believe those guys.
I can't believe anybody.
You guys know. Yeah. Y'all know that's equivalent. That's equivalent to going to a bowling alley with like
your
a certain glove and a ball.
Yeah.
And
I haven't done that.
Yeah.
But it's the same thing.
It is.
Now you've gone to meddling.
Okay. Yeah. Here's another one. If you weren't what you are, what would you be? So, like, I know you guys are traveling musicians, artists, whatever. What would you do if you weren't doing that? Maybe something, a career that you thought, man, I'd love to do that.
I went to school for marketing. I think I would apply that in some way to the music industry. So, I'd probably be working more on the business end of the music industry. So, so that's probably what I'd be doing as far as the marketing and advertising.
Very cool.
Nice.
Me?
You've all just about all you've done.
Golfing.
I'd be a great golfer. I'd work at Topgolf.
I'm going to have to really hone my skills between now. I mean, it's really going to have to pour on quickly. You know what? I will say, because we are, Angie and I just sold our house up in Michigan, and I've been doing some odds and ends around the house, and I've really enjoyed,
handyman,
a few of those things. You know, the painting end of it. Would I like to do it for a living? Probably not. Yeah. But I haven't found enjoyment in that.
Right. It is painting is relaxing sometimes.
It kind of is, you know, and especially the challenge of not taping anything off and just cutting it in.
Oh boy, you lost me there.
Like, I got a tape.
We got a tape, and it still doesn't help. We still draw outside the line. So they painted my house, and whenever y'all come over, you'll see it. There's like, got excited.
Session musician in Nashville.
Nice.
I think it'd be a lot of fun.
That's too close to what you do.
Yeah,
you're good enough to do that now.
I bet you could do that right now. Okay. So hidden hobbies, something somebody doesn't know about, like
golfing.
Yeah.
Well, we were just talking about pickleball.
No.
Pickleball.
So I think that'd be my
They're good. You're
hobby.
Good.
I can.
Lee, do you play any instruments other than percussions? Like, other than
I play drums. That's really about it. Yeah.
Trombone.
I play a little bit.
Trombone?
Yeah, I played a little trombone.
Trombone.
In school.
Yeah, that checks out.
Now, I couldn't play a note on a trombone now.
Y'all should bring that sound in.
Honestly, just imagine.
Two guitars and a trombone.
Honestly,
to try it.
Hey, actually, funny enough, y'all didn't know this because I don't know if y'all are in there. This morning at church at Dimon Avenue, saxophonist that came in. And the music pastor today didn't tell the saxophonist that they weren't playing. And so he shows up with his.
He was ready, man.
He was ready to go.
Super guy.
You should have brought him up there.
Well, no, because the music pastor was there.
We're taking over for the day.
The music pastor was there, and he said, "Oh, no, I didn't tell you, Randy. Anyway, and he's
we should have had him play with us.
He was chill. Well, actually, I got his number. He's going to want to play. He reads charts, so he's going to play. He's going to do it. We're going to Jeff Easter.
Name a prettier instrument than the saxophone.
Saxophone, man.
Hey, we're going to Jeff Easter that thing. Y'all know Jeff Easter. Jeff Easter, if he sees somebody with instruments, he's like, come on stage with us.
Yeah.
We're going Jeff Easter.
I will say, there's not much cooler than a saxophone.
No.
Oh, I love it.
That's true.
And he was reading charts. Like, he's legit.
From California.
From California. Randy.
Isn't that the guy in the toboggan?
Yep. That's exactly
that
right.
Sax player from California.
He's got to be the real deal.
He's got to be a cool guy.
Oh, he was. Super cool. Super cool guy.
she just stereotyped him. She said, was it the guy in the toboggan?
Like, Randy, he might be listening to this because we announced the podcast.
So listen, it's only because I had to experience this and explain things early on, but any of your northern friends that are listening, a toboggan is a sock hat. It's one of
a
them.
Sock hat.
Yeah, it's a sock hat, people. Because let me just say, it was cold up in Michigan when I first moved up there, which it is in the winter.
It's still cold,
and it still is. I forget what it was, maybe a Walmart or something, and I asked somebody. I said, "Where are the toboggans at?" And they pointed me over to Sporting Goods, to the sleds, and I'm like, What in the world? There's no toboggans over here. But that's what a toboggan is.
That's
a
what
sled
they constituted
up there.
As.
His brother, our uncle, he liked it. He'd like to about killed some of those workers up there because he was, show me where the toboggans are at. And they were like, it's over in Sporting Goods. And he said, I wandered around Sporting Goods for 20 minutes looking for a toboggan. And he said, and I finally went back three different times to somebody and said, where are the toboggans?
So they call it a...
Oh, my God.
It's a sled.
It's a sled. They call what we would call a toboggan.
No, what we would call a toboggan.
It's a sled.
To put on your head. No, yeah. That's a sled for them. They call it a sock hat.
I'm confused.
So they call it a
or
sock
a beanie.
Yeah.
Beanie.
I was saying, that's crazy.
Something like that.
Okay.
But
wow.
It is a sock that goes on your head.
It is. It's basically not horrible sock of a hat description. Okay. So what moment, album, or song inspired you guys to be in music? Was there one moment, maybe a concert or an album
or an
that
artist
you heard or a song? Any of that. Was there one thing that's like, oh my goodness, I would love to do that. I would love to sing. I would love to.
I'll be real with you. It was really, for us, I think, there was a couple of country bands that we listened to growing up that were really influential. Diamond Rio was one. Mm-hmm.
Ricky,
Rascal Flatts.
Ricky
Skaggs
was a big one.
You know, a lot of those guys. But then, you know, as we got into Christian music, our first real, you know, introduction to Christian music was like the Gaither Vocal Band and stuff like that. So,
Greatly blessed, highly favored.
Yes, sir. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Really so good. There was, but we grew up listening to a lot of different stuff. And really, I think those country bands early on musically really were a big inspiration to us. We listened to a lot of Rascal Flatts and stuff growing up.
And you could hear that in y'all's style. And that's a huge compliment.
So
that's incredible.
And my dad was a bluegrass player, so I grew up listening to that
yes,
and
sir.
Country music. But, you know, I would say, you know, in my formative years, that you've got, you know, Tony Rice, especially his Manzanita album.
Yes, sir.
You know, you have, you know, Newgrass Revival, those kinds of things. And then, of course, I didn't grow up in church, so I had a whole other background of other things that I was listening to. But, but you know, that shapes what you
it
do
sure
as well.
So. Jake, any word?
Any it's about the same as Levi.
Yeah.
The Ricky Skaggs, Rascal Flatts, and Diamond Rio.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What I love about this, guys, when I say guys, I mean Erwin's, what I love about this is that we're getting two different generations of answers to these questions. That's really cool because they were saying names, and then Brother Rob would come and say names. That's great. And they're the ones that put me on the Newgrass
Revival.
Oh, really?
So good.
John Cowan.
What a voice. These three are the ones that put me on that.
And speaking
people still credit Colin Baton Rouge to Garth Brooks, and we're like, nay, nay.
No, nay, nay. We seem to differ.
I do want to give a little plug because I love watching y'all's Tuesday night videos.
Oh, yes.
I know y'all cover a lot of that old country music on there. So y'all go live every Tuesday night, 7 Central, 8 Eastern, right?
So hard.
On Facebook.
It's gotten so hard.
Oh, man.
It really has.
I know y'all are because y'all are living kind of separately.
Yeah.
Now.
Yeah. When we started.
And all married, too. That makes a difference.
Yes, it does.
We started in 18.
Yep. Yeah, we're trying to navigate that right now because we started doing those videos when we all lived together. You know what I mean? We were still living at home.
Yep.
And since then, Jake and I both moved to Nashville. Of course, Dad's been still up in Michigan.
You're married now.
Yeah, we missed last week's.
Yeah. So, yeah, we did.
We were playing pickleball.
I totally forgot.
Mom gave us a call.
She's like, hey, there's not coming on.
Yeah, but the thing's gotten to be is scheduling-wise is making sure that happens. Yep. So, yeah, we've been doing that for a long time, though.
I
love it.
I'm sure really made you an audience that maybe you wouldn't have had if you didn't do it.
Yeah.
Yep. For sure.
I'll tell you when it was the best was during COVID. We had already been doing it. We had already been doing the series for a couple of years by that point. And it ended up that during COVID, we were able to put a lot of time into that. Mm-hmm. And so we had some videos that would last over an hour, you know, and we would just be.
Well, now it's nobody like was doing anything,
five minutes.
You know.
I mean, we would rehearse stuff through the week.
Yeah. Yes,
we
sir.
Would, you know, all that stuff. Now, I mean,
it's just me.
We're lucky to be able to do the video, let alone be able to rehearse anything or anything like that. So
we did a similar thing during COVID.
That's what I was
the We
say.
Challenge Wednesday thing.
Y'all were our first.
I love that.
They were our first challenge.
People ate it up.
I love that.
But we were home. We were together.
COVID.
And it's hard enough to do this.
Right.
It's a podcast. No, it's tough. Because our schedules are crazy, y'all know. I mean,
you have to do it when you're on the road.
You have
exactly.
to
exactly
you just have right. to. And unfortunately, we're not on the road on Tuesdays usually.
Yeah, right. Sometimes we have to pre-record them.
Yeah,
I get it. Life.
It's not the same. You don't have the fan interaction.
Yeah, right. Yes.
Well, I'll tell you what's been a challenge recently for us is the Instagram reels and TikTok and all that stuff. We've had some of those that have done really well. It's just getting the volume of content, and I know that the people listening to this, I don't know this. I know we all kind of relate to this, but you know, getting the volume of content because you know we've all got to be together to record it. We all have to feel good to record a good video. We've all got to, you know, we've got to be ready to go to film it. We've got to have a place to film it. You know,
so there are
a lot going into it.
Well, I remember during camp meeting one year, y'all were doing it on that Tuesday night, and y'all went to Grant Saline, I think, like a salt mine or something.
Yeah. Yep.
And y'all were just trying to find locations for it.
Yeah.
It's the same thing.
Whose town?
Kris
was that?
Tomlin.
Kris Tomlin. Yeah, that's right.
Was there someone else, or was it just Kris?
There's a lot of people from around that area.
Casey Musgraves
is Alba, and then you have Bart Millard, Greenville. Miranda Lambert is Lindell. There's a lot right in there.
How far is Cody Johnson from all that?
A few hours.
Yeah.
We're close
to three hours.
Where we're at now. We're in beautiful East Texas
Speaking of Casey Musgraves, what a voice.
Oh, man.
She's so talented.
Incredible. Yep.
She's a great voice.
That's just somebody that's out there right now that I absolutely love her voice.
Just very clean to listen to.
Yeah.
Like very, just her tone is very pretty. Yeah. Pure,
so what's the most difficult thing about what you guys do and the most enjoyable thing about what you guys do? It could be different answers. I mean,
I'd say the traveling would probably be the most difficult thing, being away from home, you know, for 3 weeks, you know, or something like that, you know.
I will say that's the most popular answer to that question.
No doubt. Yeah, I believe it.
When we said
I believe it.
See, for me, I love the traveling.
Yeah,
I always have. And so,
it's like our dad.
Yeah.
I love the fact that Angie, a lot of the time, gets to go.
Yes, she does.
You know? And that we do this as a family, you know, it's available for, you know, for Rachel or Brianna to go if they want to go.
Yes, sir.
And can make it happen. But I do realize that's a struggle.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you can't stay away from family, you know, your spouse for 3 weeks. That's a tough thing.
Yes,
and just the way we have it set up, 52 weeks in a year, and we're out for how many weeks would you say?
We've usually got, you know, a couple of shows a week. There's some weeks through the year where we don't do anything.
Yeah, right.
But actually, one of the more challenging things to work through right now is on the business side of it. Well, because there are two sides, and I don't think a lot of people see that.
Of course,
You know, there's the performance side. There's the actual live shows and things. But I mean, through the week, you know, there's a lot that goes into it. And right now, you know, we're trying to plan a lot of really big things for as far as our touring is concerned, as far as the way we play shows is concerned through the back half of 2024 and leading into 2025. And, you know, that's really at the the present time eating up a lot of my time through the week.
Yes, sir.
Is getting all of that together and then trying to find time to record new music.
Right.
Because you know, the way that we're doing it right now is and you guys have probably experienced this too with the schedule that you guys have is getting the time together to really pour into a new album or new songs or whatever, because you're really just having to take a day here, a day there, and work on it. Yeah.
It took us 3 years.
Literally three years.
And y'all are kind of, the boys, y'all are about in the same area that we're in when it comes to doing this lifestyle, newly married, you know, got married. That's a crazy thing because Levi's situation, his wife does know something about the road, does know something about travel, but that was kind of like us because my wife knew something about it. Lindsay knew something about it. Excuse me, especially like ministry, but Kayla was brand new.
Yeah.
Like Cody's wife was brand new to this. So we saw two different spectrums. Yeah. You know, and
Brandon's
and
not much of a traveler.
Yeah. Kayla's not either.
Oh, please. Okay, listen. Yeah. Brianna's not much of a traveler when it comes to like the being on the bus and the road and all that.
They're world travel. They're tourist travel.
Well, there is a difference.
That's how
Kayla is.
She likes to vacation.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, that's how Kayla is. Kayla.
Newsflash, people, traveling on a bus all the time is
not vacation.
Just so you all know.
Oh, yeah. Dude, I've had people come up. Like I'm sure in some way, shape, or form they mean well, but you know, I've had people come up and talk about like real jobs and this, that, and the other, you know, and I'm like, dude, there ain't nothing glamorous.
Hey, I take it as a compliment when they say, well, y'all are so glamorous traveling the way y'all do. It's like, you know what? That means we're making it look easy because it's true. That's a compliment because it ain't.
I don't even have a shower.
I slept at a Love's Travel Stop last night, sir.
Say that.
Exactly.
Right. Exactly right.
We didn't get any sleep because people kept knocking on the door saying, move the bus.
Yeah, I know. And that's the truth. And speaking of bus, that's the most stressful.
Oh, yeah. There's a new experience for y'all.
Oh,
yeah. A fairly new experience for y'all.
Listen, buses are—they're wonderful, but man, they are complex.
It's a beautiful convenience, but it's a lot to it.
Well, take our word for it. We just went a month without ours.
Yeah,
it's better with it.
It's better with it.
Which they did for years. How many years did y'all do with the van and the trailer? How many years was that?
About three.
Yeah,
3 years.
Yeah. Well, if you count the part-time stuff.
Well, the part-time stuff we did. The part-time 10 stuff. Years. We, yeah, the part-time stuff we did.
That's how we were.
So we went camping a lot when we were younger, when we were teenagers and stuff. So we had like a motorhome and stuff. And so we, you know, when we did stuff part-time and we weren't out nearly as much, we would take that. So it was in some respects similar to a tour bus, but at the same time, really since 2020, we were exclusively van and trailer. Mm-hmm. And then we went to a tour bus last summer. And we'll continue to. Yeah, do
I was just talking with somebody else that does the same things that we all do, that has a bus, and they were just explaining to me that they just spent like $120,000 on the engine and transmission. It's just
not surprised. I'm not either.
I'd just have to park it for a while.
Right. See you later.
Lay hands on it.
Yeah.
That's exactly right.
What else?
Fast. Yeah. That's exactly right. Yeah. You're right. It's a beautiful. What'd you say it was? It was a beautiful
convenience
when it works. But, yeah. But my goodness, it's
very complex.
All right, what about this? A little lighthearted. Introvert, extrovert. I think I know because we know you guys a little bit, but let's go down the line. Introvert or extrovert?
What are you?
Oh, I can tell you dad for sure.
What am I?
No, let's have each other.
No, yeah, you have to say it for yourself.
I would say I'm an extrovert.
Okay, yes.
I think that's if natural. You're doing this, we have to be.
It would be tough if you weren't.
But not everybody is. No,
you're right.
It seems like it would be obvious, but it's not.
It's not.
That's what our answer. Our answer is a little bit of both with what we do.
I'm mixed.
Because like you said, it's impossible for you to be an introvert with what we do. There's no way.
Right.
You can't do what you do.
You can't be a total introvert.
Not for long. You can put on for a little bit.
You can try.
Yeah.
Once we get to the pet peeves, I'll unfold this a little bit more.
I have no problem being around people, loving on people, being around and doing things and going. But I'll tell you one thing. There's some times where it is very nice to be able to just go somewhere, shut yep. a door, oh, yeah. and just yes, be sir. Off for yep. a while.
Not have you to smile, I mean? Not have right. to talk.
Right. Yeah. So I, you know, there in I would say I'm mostly extroverted, and then with a little bit of like when I go home during the week, man, like, I just I like being at home.
That's what we say.
I'm
that's
like ground exactly beef. I'm a good 80-20.
Yeah, that's yeah. it, man. I like it. Ground beef. I like that's it.
80-20.
Yeah.
And honestly,
that should be a good stage name. Yeah. Ground beef.
There's already a meatloaf. Get ready yeah. for ground beef.
Ground beef. Ground beef.
I like it. And honestly, what Levi said is exactly what Kody said. We're that's exactly how we yeah. are. We're kind of a mix, yeah. you know. And we, you know, we know when we need to. And mostly introvert, extrovert. I mean, most.
For
of
instance,
us.
When we're at church and stuff, we talk. To yep. a bunch of people. Constantly. When we yep. get on the bus, we don't talk
we
to
all go to our bus immediately.
Yeah, yeah. We do.
Yeah, we do. But you, usually late at night, we'll eat supper together or whatever, and then we'll yeah. just shut off, shut sure. away from each other.
And you
other.
Got to. I think it's healthy.
Yeah.
Oh. I mean, in order to be back where you need to be the next day,
sure.
it's like, hey, you got to recharge.
Yep. Well, yeah, let yeah. me tell you, I got like, yeah, a perfect example. When I'm at home, I don't like scheduling things to do because when we're like as non-work related, just as far as like, hey, I get when I'm home in Nashville, you know, all the friends is like, hey, let's go downtown tonight and whatever. Yeah. I'm like, dude, I just got back from being out nope. for 10 right. days yep. and I would very much like to just be home
and
tonight.
For me, I would be like, oh, when, what time you want to meet?
I know. He's
that's
way.
Our dad.
He's
man.
Like, what do you mean? Hey, you want to go downtown?
That's
yeah,
a
where
good
are we
point.
Going?
I'm already there.
Yeah, I'm, what do you mean? I'm already there.
I'm waiting on somebody to call. I'm waiting on somebody to call.
You don't mind, I'm at, oh, I don't have time to get in the shower. Okay, well, I'll meet you there.
Dude, that's a great point, Levi, because we have friends, like you're just saying, that live around us, that are good friends, great people, that always say, man, we need got to get together, got to go for supper or whatever. But that's the problem, is you normally have at maybe 4 days, but 3 days, sometimes a week on the, at home. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And, dude, that's for recuperation.
That's my yes. weekend.
That's your recuperation.
Monday, Tuesday, and sometimes because, Wednesday yeah. is my my weekend.
Because yes. Honestly, it takes, what, at least 24 hours to recuperate from what you have. And then it takes 24 hours to get ready for what you're going, where you're going.
Yeah. Yep.
And so you only have just the next amount of time for your family. Now you're married and you got family. Yeah. And so it's a crazy thing that we have to juggle our lives. Yeah. And you know what? God gives us strength. God gives us wisdom. He puts our wives, the right people in our lives. Isn't yep. that amazing how yeah. God just sets that up? And that's why it's important to follow the will of God, young people that are listening.
Yes,
that's
right.
That's why it's important
absolutely.
To follow the will of God. And so
yoked equally.
That's right. Yes. That's exactly right. Yes. What's your favorite thing about the recording process? So, and it can be anything, like from start to finish. Now, before I you answer this, I'll get you time to think about it. You're listening to three. They don't get enough credit for this. You're listening to three incredible songwriters.
Yes,
these guys will write. They write 90%. I would say of what you hear on a concert. I would say right.
Good 80-20.
Yeah. Good 80-20. Good ground beef.
I think we got our.
I think we got our episode name. Ground beef with the sound.
Ground beef with the.
We kind of figure. We kind of organically make our episode name as we go. So anyway, but yeah, so because these guys will write most of what their material on stage, and it's incredible. And so, but I wanted to preface that, but yeah. give you all the props you deserve.
That is a hard question for me.
I'll say I like the creativity. And again, from the songwriting end of yep. it, from where it's birthed to...
Yes, sir.
To seeing it,
see it bloom.
Come to fruition.
Yes, sir.
It's really... I do enjoy that part.
I've got a soft spot for vocal production, but at the same time, I really love like the arrangement process of bringing a work tape to like an actual tracking session and getting all of that recorded. It's definitely a unique process, and one of the most fun experiences I think that I've had making a record. Is when we recorded our God is Real album, you know, we cut the song I Didn't Find Jesus. Yep. And if you would have heard what was tracked, like the band tracked that day, we did a tracking session, it was different than what actually ended up on the record. And the version that ended up on the record, I mean, we went in with Barry, our producer, and you know, we took out certain parts and certain sections, and we left. Yeah, I remember the opening, the intro to the song, that acoustic guitar. The whole band originally played the intro. Oh, wow. And wow. And so when we were in that tracking session, we after the fact, we just ducked everything else out. And we were like, what if we did that? You know what I mean? What if we just started with
it's a drastic change. Yeah.
So it is.
The tracking to
from what he's describing to what it is. Absolutely it is.
Yeah. So it was a lot of fun.
Now, and your producer, you just kind of named it. What Barry Weeks.
Barry Weeks. Produced the guy that's
right. His name.
He's done a lot for, was it
Booth
Brian
Brothers.
Free and
Francesca Battistelli. He's done like all of her records.
Okay.
He did, what's the song, Booth Brothers? What's that album from
2006? He saw it all.
What's the first
song? Testify.
I've got to
That's a great jam.
That's him at the beginning acting as the pastor.
Is it really?
Yeah, it is.
I did not know that. I've never met Barry, and I'd love to, because I think he was at, I think that's the only time I think I've seen him, is he was on stage with y'all at the Dove Awards when you went to Dove. I remember seeing him, because I watched it that night. But I'd love to meet him, because he's kind of been the soundtrack of my childhood in a lot of ways with that record.
Yeah,
and with Brian Free, man, in the heyday, which I think they're still in their heyday, but
absolutely.
Like those records that Brian Free did when they had the quartet.
Yep. Yes, yeah. I thought that was him.
Yeah.
What's that a cappella song by Brian Free?
There is a kingdom coming.
There is a kingdom coming.
So good.
Yes.
Is he in Nashville? Is that where Barry lives?
He's in Nashville. Yeah. Stuff from Golly.
Is it Columbia? Isn't that where it's at?
Somewhere down
there. Yeah, I see.
Yeah. Spring Hill.
Spring Hill.
I want to meet him.
He's south of town.
Yeah, he's a great guy.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
Rapid fire questions.
Whoops. All right.
Go ahead. We need, let's find a, because we need to go one line. Let's go from right to left, my right to left. So you first, and then we're going down the line.
Cool.
And this is quick. How do you take your coffee? Black cream or sugar?
I don't really drink coffee, but if I had to, it'd be cream, like a lot of it, mostly.
Cream. Ice cream.
Cream.
Okay. Text or a caller?
Call.
Too long.
Call.
Too long.
Call.
Call.
80-20.
I like ground beef.
Which one? Which one?
Ground beef. Which one's 80?
80 text, 20 call.
Okay.
What's your?
You never answer any of that,
dude. That's Kris right here.
Never answer any of it.
What's your Chick-fil-A go-to order?
Ooh, 8-count number 3, large with a sweet tea, extra ice, and like 4 Chick-fil-A sauces.
That one's pretty elaborate. Okay.
Cobb salad.
No Chick-fil-A sauce.
Yeah, with the good nuggets. I don't do that grilled stuff. I want the good nuggets.
There you go, Rob.
Okay. Number 1 meal, large with the sweet tea with extra ice. Sunjoy with extra ice.
If you said 80-20 ground beef, I would have
laughed. Yes, so good.
Okay. Mexican food or Italian?
Italian.
Mexican.
Mexican.
Yes, my boys. Whataburger or In-N-Out?
Whataburger.
Whataburger.
In-N-Out.
We almost had the trifecta.
Hey, I will tell you this. The Whataburger In-N-Out thing, dude, Whataburger's got them beat, but I don't think either one of them are the best.
Five Guys.
I don't think either one of them are the best.
Well, then what would you consider the best?
Shake and Shake.
Yeah.
What would you
I'm just looking at Kris right now for those of you that couldn't know. I think Five Guys got the best burger by far.
Yep. Dude. See, close. I wouldn't even put them in the same category, though. It's not even the same price point. Whataburger.
It used to be Five Guys.
Exactly. So to me, In-N-Out, Whataburger, and then you got like Freddy's, Culver's, and you had like because they're steak burgers.
I think ground beef knows what he's talking about.
Yeah, I would go for 80-20 over there.
All right.
I did see a drive through at a Five Guys the other day. Yeah. So
technically,
flip flops or boots?
Boots.
Oh, I knew that. Well, you?
I would say flip flops.
Flip flops.
Flip flops. I'm a flip flops guy.
Levi's a boot rocker.
Yeah, he's always
wearing some right now.
Okay, that was rapid fire questions, and as usual, y'all win nothing.
Oh, there you go.
You're welcome. Okay, so
we haven't done the share song.
No, we're going to get to that. So we're doing so a couple more segments.
Okay.
Mount Rushmore of singers. I need 12 people. So 4-4-4.
Yep.
12 is that good
math?
People.
Look at that math for homeschooler. Okay.
Wow.
And it doesn't have to necessarily be different, but just your top four. And
I got to narrow it down to 4. Okay.
Our Hoover's ready. Go ahead.
Well, I can tell you, I'm going to try to do it fairly. I'm going to try to go 2 men and 2 women here.
Okay. Come on.
I'll start with the women. The two that I have the biggest debates on with everybody else. Celine Dion and Whitney Houston.
Mm-hmm. I'm not going to debate a whole lot there.
Okay. Those are top two.
Okay.
Female singers of all time. Men. I'm going to have to.
There's a guy from Michigan that was really good back in the day that I loved. Old McDonald.
I know.
Oh, yeah, dude. I thought you were going to say Bob Seger.
Don't interrupt him.
I'm sorry.
I'm going
to
go.
They're thinking. I'm just trying to pass time. I'm filibustering.
I'll tell you who I listen to a lot and who is one of the greatest singers of all time, bar none, is Steve Perry.
Okay.
I'll throw Steve in there because if I had more time to think about it, it might be different. But I'm going to go Steve Perry and Ooh.
Stevie
Wonder.
Stevie Wonder.
Yeah. Two Steves. I just put that down.
Two Steves. Okay, y'all two. Go ahead.
Well, okay, so I realize you guys are doing the what you feel the greatest of all time, and that's great. I'm gonna do the people that influenced me.
Okay, that's
do
fine.
It. You can on maneuver. My Mount Rushmore. Do it. Can
you
I do that?
You can maneuver. Yeah. I got a different list for that then.
Well, that's fine. Yeah, you can do when it comes to you. You can do your list.
80-20.
Build your mountain.
80-20.
You build your mountain. I'll build my own mountain. Thank you very much. But I've got a couple different people. I think Tony Rice, I said earlier. Yes. I think George Jones had probably the, as far as country music, the best country voice. And I would say, I think Aretha Franklin is fantastic.
Mm. How many of those?
I mean,
is
just,
that four?
That's three. Three.
No, I've only got three so far. Okay.
You still got to build. You're still building.
He's just like, I didn't hear my name. What?
And because we're in Texas,
come on.
I think somebody else that's been very influential is Willie Nelson.
Nelson,
he just
old
is.
Old brother,
I mean,
William, say that.
His writing. I mean, right. if you dove into country music,
I believe the
music,
question
his,
was singers.
That's okay. His
hey, Willie counts.
You're in Texas, oh, William.
Willie counts.
So that's
you I get shot at if you say that too loudly. Right?
You better watch out around here, brother.
Them boots will be
flying.
Right, right.
Take the boots off of you.
Now.
Jake, are you ready for your...
I don't think...
Are
you ready to build your... Let me just say, I think that's the only time I've ever heard Willie Nelson mentioned on a greatest singers of all time. Greatest singers of all time.
Hey, no influential.
Willie Nelson.
No judgment. Jake?
Well, I'm going to put Stevie Wonder. Yep. Levi said that, and I agree. Whitney Houston and Ella Fitzgerald and Michael Bolton.
Yeah.
That's right.
Oh, Michael's a good... That's a good one,
brother.
Yeah. That's good. Those
Michael
are
Bolton.
So
man,
good.
I knew y'all were going to come through with some good singers. Y'all are music connoisseurs.
How do you always... Like, I don't know how you even narrow it down, man, because, I mean, Aretha,
you didn't,
Ella...
You didn't even put Gary LaVox in there.
I know. Well, that's the thing. Is
yeah,
like
but you only gave me four.
I know.
I did say Mount Rushmore.
That's what we don't need a choir.
You know, we don't need a choir. We just need a mountain.
I'll tell you what, it's a lot harder for me. It's a lot harder for me to narrow down four female singers than it is male singers.
Yeah.
I mean, there's been a lot of male singers that have influenced me and stuff, don't get me wrong, but as far as some of the most incredible voices that I have ever heard, a lot of them are women.
It's women,
no
a
doubt.
A lot of them are women.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. Okay, here's... Here's a fun. Here's
sorry,
a fun Kate, one.
Sorry, Katie. He didn't.
Here's a fun one. Don't. Here's a fun one. Pet peeve. Y'all have any pet peeves? And while y'all are thinking, I've got one.
I got one.
Okay, go ahead, Christopher.
Yeah. Listen, it's the year of our Lord 2024. You're not supposed to, in any way, shape, or form, go up to anybody and talk about their weight.
Yeah.
In any shape or form, like, it's not acceptable.
No,
that's not. True. This isn't cancel culture. I'm talking about. This is just common courtesy.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Unless you are their parent.
Yep.
Or someone extremely close to them.
Yep.
I don't care if it's
talk about this.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Right. Like,
if I don't know you.
Yeah. Dude, wait. No matter what extreme, whether it be, are you pregnant?
Yeah.
Or are you sick? I don't care. Either extreme. Get rid of it.
I would have just apologized to you. I'm sorry. You didn't have to
No, it's not. It wasn't you.
This is fired up.
But no, I'm just saying.
You didn't have to bring it up on the podcast. If you had just told me, I would have apologized.
I'm just saying, I'm just saying. Weight is it's off the table. That's
yeah.
Weight is a taboo topic.
I thought that was like never ask a woman their age kind of thing.
Yeah, right.
Yeah,
right.
No, it's a thing.
Yeah.
Like, what? You think.
Here's Listen, one. You're not going to win that.
Here's one. Right? Our buddy, brother Mark Zuckerberg. Has put a new... Old brother Mark Zuckerberg has put a new option on Facebook to where you can highlight and you could have... Nope. You could basically tag all of your friends.
Oh, at followers?
Yes.
Yeah.
And so, dude, I love a lot of my followers, I should say. Not all of them. I love a lot of my friends
who do not like
followers on Facebook.
Name them Keith.
But, dude, I'm telling you, and I love 90... No, that's way too far.
80-20.
I love like
80-20.
I love 20% of what I see on Facebook. But, dude, if I why am I getting highlighted and stuff? Come on.
They
man.
Just want you to see
I saw the I funniest know. Thing the other day, too. It said, it was, you know how people like do those copy and paste this to stop whatever? I saw a thing the other day. It said, tomorrow starts the new rule where Mark Zuckerberg can sneak into your kitchen and eat your food. If you want to stop him, copy and paste this message to your Facebook.
Oh, my
actually,
gosh.
That's a good one.
That's great.
Someone said, Nana's going to be on there tomorrow.
Yeah,
copy. Any more to add to our time of grievance?
Pet peeves.
Okay, I'll go a pet peeve that really can only happen in private, and then a pet peeve that is a very public pet peeve, like what you guys brought up. The far left lane is the passing lane. It's not the fast lane. Yep. It's not the what. It is the passing lane. If you are not passing somebody, stop driving in the left lane.
Get over.
That'll preach.
Get over.
I'll get you 18 wheelers.
Dude.
That's facts. That's good.
18 wheelers, especially in the bus. Those 18 wheelers are riding next to each other.
Yes.
Yeah, they are.
Same speed.
30 miles.
I know. And I'm going
We're only going 80 in the bus. I mean, get over.
And the one that's doing quote unquote passing is doing like a half a mile an hour
like
faster
a
than the
snail.
I'm like, we're going to be here for days. We're going to be here.
That's true.
Private pet peeve is when I purposely like leave something somewhere in the house or on the bus or something. And somebody comes along and goes, "Ooh, I think I should pick this up and move it,
and or throw it away,
and put it somewhere where nobody would ever think to look."
Rachel, he loves you. He loves you. Don't.
It is my brother.
Oh boy,
and Rachel. They both.
This is what we like. Fight.
He'll just come along and he'll go, "Oh, is this paper?
I'm guilty. I'm guilty of that.
He is guilty of that.
You know where this should go? In this closet, in the back cupboard, under the shoe.
Well, hey, if they don't want us picking up after them, then they should do it themselves.
That's exactly right.
Well, that's exactly right. Yeah.
Wow.
Crickets.
Crickets. Nice. Okay. Any more?
I texted Brianna because I can't think of anything right now, but she could probably think of a couple.
What don't I like?
His wife goes, "What are my pet peeves?
What do I not like?
Seriously, what am I allowed to say here?" Yeah. She said me.
Whatever.
Oh, no. We love you, Bri.
I love you, Bri.
Hey, I'll give you one. New bus driver now. It's the Cracker Barrel or like RV parking, cars parked.
Yeah.
That's bad.
Great. Why do they do that?
I don't know. It says bus RV parking.
Yeah. You know,
and you're neither.
In Nashville at the Opera Mills Mall, they've got
a lot there.
15 spots. Yep.
We've been
buses.
Right there by the Opry. By
that. And I'm telling you, everybody parks in those things.
Yeah. Praise Fest.
The buses got nowhere to go.
Exactly. In Praise Fest in Branson on the right, if you're looking at the venue on the y'all saw it.
Yeah.
Bus park, and then there's cars everywhere in it.
Everywhere.
Yep. Crazy.
So, newsflash, you guys, don't park in it where it says RV parking or bus parking.
We need it.
We can't park in car parking.
That's right.
There's probably some people listening to this podcast that parked in the bus parking.
Yeah, they're probably listening to it in the parking spot.
Yeah.
We love you.
We love
Kody
you.
Just
we're just calling
you out.
In
Jesus' name. We're calling you out.
Left lane all the way here, and now I've got this big parking spot.
Seriously.
We're calling you out, but we love you in Jesus' name.
No, I mean, seriously, I can look out, like, when we can, whether we're driving in the bus or whether I'm driving in a car or something, there's no, I mean, the road is clear.
Yep.
Like, there's nobody, and I'll have somebody just driving in the left lane.
Yep.
And it's worse when they're only going, like, 65 miles an hour in a 70.
Yep.
That's the worst. Mm-hmm. But even if you're driving, like, kind of quick, it doesn't hurt you to just stay in the lane you're supposed to be in and swing out when you pass somebody.
Right. Yeah,
that's right.
His peeves have been petted.
All peeves have been petted.
Guys, Brianna said,
I know how to pray for school.
Being late.
Don't go there, Jake.
That's a good one.
These three are the latest. Keith is the latest.
Oh, no.
Listen.
Kris is the latest.
Christopher is the latest.
I say call time at the bus, noon.
He showed up at 2 o'clock.
Like 12:35, I've got people rolling in. I'm like, why in the world? What? Yep. Okay, well, tomorrow.
See, we're all on the same boat.
Levi's late.
We're all on the same boat.
I'm glad it's not just us.
I understand.
Hey, listen, usually run late, but I can. Don't let these two tell you they don't run late either.
I know. See,
I'll tell you what.
Everybody. I'm not late.
Yes, you have been.
I have been.
Yes, you have.
But
you
I am. So
you literally
not
can't
late.
Do that, though.
Typically
but
not
you,
late.
But you can't.
If I'm late, I'm late on purpose because I know y'all are going to be late.
Yeah,
so
listen,
I'm like, you know what? I'm
giving it works. Be late once and they have an excuse for it.
Oh, brother. It's terrible.
See?
Listen, you were late once.
That's right.
Okay.
Yeah, but you're late.
Grace died 40 years ago.
Grace.
Say Grace.
Okay. So we're going to end on this kind of note. So, like I said, a couple different generations here. If you could go back and say something to your younger self about what you're doing, what advice maybe would you tell that younger person, a younger Levi, younger Rob, younger Jake, what would you tell that person, personally, you, what would you tell yourself, you know, 20 years ago, 10 years ago, whatever, however long, whatever.
Get the 90-10 ground beef.
I was about to say, he's going beef.
He's going beef.
I would tell myself about the ground beef 80-20 rule.
Yeah. Well, I know it's kind of a deep question, but if you have anything.
And Rob, like, Rob is about the a particular Rob subject, or just in
like
general,
kind of about what you do. Like, what do you think? Maybe your ministry, and like, or you maybe, what would you say?
I would say, just really take in the experiences that you have, because those experiences are they're here today and they're gone. Yeah. And then really all you do is get to look back at it. It just relish those experiences, because I mean, they don't come around all the time, you know.
Same with the people that we encounter.
Yeah,
as well. There's people that have passed away that have blessed our ministry,
right?
You know, greatly, likewise. And they're not here anymore. You know,
100%.
And learn to play the guitar, Rob. For goodness' sake.
You've already done that.
I wish I knew more.
Oh man, yeah. Isn't that funny? You can never learn. You're never an expert.
No, because I listen to other players play, and I'm like, I'll always never, something to work on. Obviously, I'm never going to do that.
Always.
I'll go more on the business side. I mean, you learn a lot as you go. You know what I mean? I think all three of us are a lot wiser now on the business side of things than we were several years ago. And it would have been nice to know some of the things that we know now earlier on, to save a lot of time and a lot of headache and a lot of, you know. So definitely could have warned myself there not necessarily warned, but prepared.
Yeah, I get it.
You know what I mean? Not necessarily a warning, but more preparation.
Yes, sir.
And then, I mean, on the personal end of it, I would have probably put a lot more time into practicing music honestly, I'm 26. There's a lot of things that I really haven't practiced doing. You know what I mean?
Yeah, right.
I'm a drummer. I'm an okay drummer, but you know, I could have definitely put in a lot more practice time there. I can play a little bit of keys. I probably could have, you know, worked on that a lot harder when I was younger. So
it's good.
There's a lot of that.
And I would say, Rob, Angie lives in Michigan.
Go find her.
Michigan.
Way earlier. That's a good answer, brother Rob.
Thank you. Make sure she hears that.
I will. Yeah.
Luke, keep that in.
Don't take that. That's
turn it up.
Luke.
Turn it up. Right.
Turn that
there.
Up. Make sure Angie hears that. So quick, give us like the information, social media, website, wherever they can find.
Wait, did Jake give the? I don't think Jake gave advice. Wait,
no,
you did.
You did. People.
Okay, what were you?
Love the people that God gives you. Before we go on, we gotta share a song.
Okay, we'll do that. Let's do that now.
Let's do that first.
Let's do that now.
Share a song.
So like a song that you guys have heard recently. We're all going to do this. We do this because really, I'll tell y'all, a lot of emails that we get from this outlet, they will say, man, I've never heard this group or I've never heard this song. Thank you for telling us about it. So people are kind of following just to kind of hear some new music.
Well, I was going to throw out a Glenn Campbell song.
Okay.
You're talking one of our songs?
No. It could be any artist.
Any song.
It could be new, old.
Yep.
We do a lot of new stuff.
Okay.
Yeah, we have covered y'all many times.
Okay. I'll kick us off here.
Go ahead.
I'm going to go Step by Step by Natalie Grant and Dolly Parton. Mm. That whole album is really fun. She has a bunch of collabs with different artists. She released a couple months ago, Natalie Grant, but Step by Step.
Fun.
I got Motel Bible by Scotty Inman.
Ayo.
Great song.
Yes,
you've heard
is.
That.
Is it good?
Yes,
great.
It is.
It's powerful. And our boy Levi Bowman co-wrote it.
Nice.
With,
that's right.
With, I'm fixing to have to get this right here.
Jimmy Erie, right?
Jimmy Erie, and then there's a third. There's a lady that helped. I'm fixing to play it on my phone here. Doesn't say. Oh my goodness, he doesn't have it set on his Apple Music. There's another lady that also co-wrote, and I give her props, even though I don't know her name. Great song.
Rain, the sound.
Rain,
the sound. That's
never heard of them.
Never heard of them. What group is that?
What?
Rain,
okay.
The sound.
You're just saying.
It is a good song. No,
great song.
We've given you props on this before. Cody.
The studio cut's great, but go pull up live videos of them doing it too. It's amazing.
God of the Hills and Valleys. Taryn Wells.
That's an old one.
Yeah, Hills and Valleys.
I've been listening with the girls. It's a Taryn Wells radio on Spotify. And they just got a bunch of old worship stuff and the girls dig it.
Yep.
And I dig
good
it.
Song.
It's
cool.
Man, it's a good song. What cut?
Because I know there's 50 different.
The one that's on this is the Valleys version, just all it says. Uh-huh. I guess it's his
yeah,
cut.
Yeah.
That's great. It's maybe a live cut.
It's great.
For me, I'm going to go back old school that I've been listening to recently is Stephen Curtis Chapman's Great Adventure album.
You cannot beat that.
That's a great, the whole album's great.
Stephen Curtis.
We may have to do that later tonight, too.
Oh, yeah.
We do have a concert tonight.
So
we do have to think of some songs we can do together. So
tell the devil Joseph.
Oh, brother Joe.
Y'all hear
love that song. Hey, Joe.
And he debuted, we were with him last night, he debuted a new one.
Did he really?
Yeah.
What was it called? Do you remember?
Do you remember the name of it? It talked about Tennessee.
Yeah, it was...
What church? Was it about the church?
Yeah. Rocky Top?
Yeah, I've heard about the church.
Rocky Top. Rocky Church out of me.
Big bold, bold move. Bold move.
I think is what it's called. He didn't actually say the song title.
Yeah, he's talking about the church, though. Talking about
the
church.
Yeah.
Can't get the church.
How he let, yeah. That's it. That's cool. It.
That's a good song. He's got a good, he's powerful right. record coming up, y'all.
He's really, it's really good.
Levi?
It's down to me.
It's down to you.
All right. I'm not going to share the one that I was going to share because it's way out in left field. But
come on. You can do two.
Okay. I'm going to go. The Christian song that I've been listening to a lot lately is Running Home, Cochran and Company, or anything by We the Kingdom, honestly.
Yes.
I will. And I don't know if y'all agree with me or not on this, but I genuinely, wholeheartedly think that musically, We the Kingdom just might be one of the greatest bands that's ever existed in the space of Christian music.
Yeah. I agree.
Yeah,
Franny is incredible.
Yeah,
yes, she is.
She's so good.
That first record they did.
She's not with them anymore, but she's great.
No, I can't disagree with that.
Yeah, we saw them live.
Yeah,
very good.
They're great.
Yeah,
I don't know the last time I've enjoyed. I mean, I don't know the last time I've enjoyed a record quite as much as that debut record that they put out in. I think it was 2020. Mm-hmm. That was fantastic.
Kane's record is new. The new record is good. The Jesus music.
Kane's fantastic.
It's good.
Man. Very good. They've one of the things I appreciate about Kane is they've really got a good thing going in the space that they exist in. See, they did that Rise Up record that was really incredible and great debut album by any metric. But then this one that they just put out, you know, I feel like every artist to a certain extent, you know, kind of cuts away what they feel didn't work as well on the previous record and moves, you know, tries to find a sound or something moving forward.
Yeah.
And I definitely feel like they have really found a sound that they are very comfortable in and that they are really good at.
Yeah. No doubt.
It's natural.
It's natural to them.
It's natural for them. Natural. So.
Okay. So now we can get to like socials and website and stuff. Where could people find you?
Yeah. Instagram, TikTok, at Real The Sound, R-E-A-L The Sound. Facebook, if you just search The Sound and hit pages, will come up. By the way, I think all of them, maybe not TikTok, I think all of them have the blue check. So if it doesn't have a blue check, don't follow it.
No, don't follow Ernie Haas and The Sound, okay?
Yeah, no, that's not the one.
No, that's not the right one.
No, The Sound on Facebook. If you search at Real, R-E-A-L, The Sound on Instagram and TikTok, we're on there. Our website's thesound.org. You can find pretty much anything about us on there.
We met on the cruise. Is that right? Did we meet on
Music Scott City show?
On a Music City show?
That's it.
And isn't that amazing?
You used my guitar to write a... What song was it that you guys wrote?
This is Love. That was 2020.
Yep.
We met in 2020 then, 4 years ago.
It's actually... Okay, so we met in 2019.
Yeah.
We met in 2019 on the boat. We did the next cruise in 2020.
Right, yeah. Oh, was
and
that
I think
when
that's
you guys...
really where we...
Yes, sir.
Like, I think the first time we kind of knew each other, played Mafia, that kind of thing. Like, 2020, I feel like we all really got to know each other on the boat. That was a fun cruise. And then we got off and the world shut down.
We had no clue.
For real.
We're lucky we got off that boat.
Oh my goodness.
Aren't we?
And y'all have become some of our best friends.
Well, it's mutual.
We love y'all so much.
These guys, shucks.
I'm telling you guys, that's the truth. They're family to us.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, if y'all have never heard of The Sound, I'm telling you, do yourself a favor.
Yes.
Climb out from under that rock and go listen to this music because it's some of the highest quality music in our genre right now. In any genre of Christian music, any subgenre of Christian music. So, and they're hard workers and they're great men. Like I said, they love people. And so it's an easy thing to just listen to these guys. And it's a fun concert and it's enjoyable time. And so we love you guys.
Yes. Yeah. Well, thank you all so much for coming on.
Thanks for doing this.
And by the way, you all, I know, and it's not just because you said it about us, but I do want to take a second and congratulate you guys because you just put out a new album.
Yep.
Woo! Yeah.
And we just want you guys to know we're proud of you guys and you guys work hard. You guys make a good product. You're doing it well, and you're doing it right.
Very much.
And we love you guys, and we're proud of you.
It means a lot coming from you.
We're cheering you on.
Yes, sir. That's the same. We're on the same team here, boys and girls.
Now, which is your favorite of us?
No!
Love y'all.
See you guys.
Bye.
Thanks for joining us for this episode, and please take a moment to follow us on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, or wherever you listen to podcasts. It would be really helpful and appreciated if you could leave us a 5-star review and share this podcast with your friends. Also, if you want to reach out to the Erwins with any questions, comments, or feedback about the podcast, simply send an email to 4kpod@yahoo.com. That's FourKPod@yahoo.com. You can also see the show notes for that email address, and we're really excited to hear from you. And you never know, if you send an email with a question, it may just be featured on a future episode. This podcast is hosted by Keith, Kody, Kris, and Katie Erwin, and it's produced by myself, Luke Clayton, and my team at mustincrease.com. Thank you once again for joining us for this episode, and we look forward to seeing you next time right here on 4Ks in a Pod with the Erwins.
Bring on the fire, bring on the rain. My testimony is not gonna change. From the valley to the mountain, he's worthy of praise. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story. Whatever comes before me, I'm still telling my story. Still telling my story.